Welcome back to Proactive, where I'm talking to Andrew Duxbury now. He's the Chief Financial Officer over at Galliford Try Holdings. And Andrew, it is fantastic to have you on the line. I think it's the first time that we're speaking this year, and we're going to be talking a bit about your trading update. But before we do that, could you just remind the audience a bit about the business and what it does?
Yeah, of course. And really nice to speak to you again, Thomas. So yeah, Galliford Try, we're a UK-based construction company. We build critical social and economic infrastructure across the UK in really important sectors, so schools, prisons, defence, water, roads, and so on. And I think, Thomas, one thing I would just draw out from that, what's really important is that those are not cyclical sectors. Those are sectors which work over the long term, and they all offer us sustainable growth opportunities as we go forwards.
Thank you very much indeed, Andrew. So we've got today's update. Looks very positive, strong cash position, strong order book, but probably the single biggest takeaway, I guess, for your investors is that you are increasing your guidance for the year to June. What can you tell us?
So all parts of the business, Thomas, are in really good shape. We've got some really, businesses are all performing strongly, performing very consistently. So our building business has got a really good pipeline of work, made some really good wins in the period. It won a just as an example, £87 million private rented sector contract in North London. And it also has started work on our first development scheme, which is down in Cardiff. So really good set of work across all of its sectors. Our highways business, again, is working really well. That signed up a couple of jobs earlier in calendar 2023, which is now making good progress on. So for example, up in Carlisle, another job in Melton Mowbray. And our environment business, which is mainly water, again, that works with all the major water companies across the UK. Huge amount of work there and doing really well. And again, there was our most recent acquisition in that part of the business was in November. We spoke about that last time I came on your show. So all parts of the business are performing well. As you mentioned, in September, we increased our guidance for the year to June 2024. And because of the strength of the performance since then, because of the our people, our supply chain, the work that they're doing, we've been able to increase our guidance again. So we've guided to a further 5% uplift on revenue and profit before tax for the year to June 2024.
You're painting quite a positive picture, of course, Andrew, but in terms of potential spanners in the works, it is an election year. Do you see any potential problems emanating from a change of government or even a continuation of the current one?
Yeah, so I don't see any big risk in this. So sometimes people ask me about any hiatus coming into a general election cycle. What I'll remind you is when we started this financial year in July, we had 92% of this year's revenue already in hand. We had about 75% of revenue through to the year to June 2025 already in hand. And of course, both of those positions are improved now. So we've got a really good piece of work and secured work, which takes us through the general election cycle. So that's really important as well. So we're well placed to work our way through any kind of disruption or hiatus that there might be. And then in terms of outcome, I mean, Dr. Thomas, don't know any better than anybody else what the outcome of the election will be. But in terms of the scope of the work that we do, the size of projects, the type of projects, the sectors that we work in, all of those I see continuing, whatever the colour of the next government, the work we do in schools, in prisons, in defence, in water, and so on. These are really important projects, and they're something which will continue and typically continue under all types of government.
Just finally, Andrew, last time you came and spoke to us back in November, you were focusing quite a lot on your sustainable growth strategy. It was something that you originally set out back in 2021. Could you give us an update today on how you're progressing against those specific objectives?
Yeah, of course. So just to remind you, so what we said in 2021 is that by 2026, we'd grow the business to 1.6 billion turnover at 3% operating margins. And that's from 1.1 billion at 2% in 2021. So really good growth. And we're making really good progress against those objectives. That's really based on a culture of risk management, culture of discipline, our strong financial position. But given that excellent progress, what we said today, Thomas, is that we will look to update those targets through to 2030, later on this year. So in probably the second quarter of 2024, we'll give additional guidance through to 2030 because we're making such good progress on the targets that we set out in 2021.
Great to have you on, Andrew. Hopefully we won't have to wait until the second quarter to hear from you again, but all the very best to you until next time.
Okay, thanks very much, Thomas.